First question is from Brian Pata. Can you guys break down how to analyze a physique with terms like origins, insertions, muscle bellies, etc.? I've heard these terms thrown around a lot, and I'd love to learn from you guys about it.
All right, Justin.
Yeah.
Tell us.
No, I got this.
I'm going to defer to Justin.
I'm going to steer this conversation where I want it to go.
Really, what you're going to look for is, you know, that sort of like symmetrical V tapering, you know, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Come on, guys, help me.
Is that what I sound like when I talk about basketball or football?
100%.
Yeah.
I just know enough terms to like pretend I'm in this conversation.
Yeah. So these are all terms that were used and created and by the physique presentation spaces and industry.
Well, some
bodybuilding.
Some of them is anatomy, right? So origin and insertion is just where the muscle attaches to the bone. Right?
Yeah,
so,
but the way that that they use it in anatomy and the way bodybuilders use it is a little different. So,
I'll give you that.
Yeah, so these are terms that were...
the bodybuilders that are using that are just trying to sound fucking smart.
Yeah, he's got nice calf insertions. The insertions are the same.
Yeah.
Okay, so these are terms that were used by bodybuilders, physique competitors, the judges, you know, bikini competition, fitness competition figure, to kind of explain the, you know, what causes someone to look like to have the right aesthetics for that sport. So bodybuilding aesthetics, you know, what are they looking for? They're looking for a good shoulder to waist ratio. Typically, the wider the shoulders and the smaller the waist, the better. They're also looking for symmetry. Symmetry meaning that both sides of the body match. You know, your right and left match. Balance. Well, balance means, does my chest overpower my back or vice versa? Do my legs match my upper body? Do I have big upper legs, but do I have small calves? That would be...
Do you have dry glutes, bro? You know what I mean?
Actually, that is
a good one.
I'm glad you said that.
Yeah, yeah. Striated glutes right there.
Yes. When someone says you're very, oh man, he came in real dry. What they mean is not only are you lean, but you don't have any water under your skin, so you look like an anatomy chart, right? You're shredded. Striations refer to the lines and the muscle and all that stuff. So origin insertion in this context means how big or how long is the bicep?
Yeah, I would say how long or how bubbly.
Yeah.
Right? So someone's going to say they have like a long origin insertion if they have like a big, big, long muscle. If they have like a short, small, bubbly, like a Columbo, like a physique.
Yes.
Versus Arnold, right?
Yes.
Arnold would be like, oh, he has long origin insertions, and Columbo would be he's got the short origin insertion.
What a great example. Look at Franco Columbo's bicep if you want. You could pause the podcast, look it up, put Google Franco Columbo's bicep. And then Google Arnold Schwarzenegger's bicep. And one thing you'll notice besides the different shape is that Arnold's bicep seems to be longer. It seems to get closer to the elbow than Franco Columbo's bicep does. So that's what they're talking about with muscle bellies, insertions, and origins. Now in bodybuilding, long muscle bellies it looks more aesthetic because, you know, if I have a calf that is really short and up near my knee versus a calf that seems to go all the way down to my ankle, when you develop both of them, the one that seems to go down to the ankle is just going to look bigger. It just seems to be more visually appealing from a bodybuilding standpoint. What a great picture. Actually, Doug pulled up a picture of Arnold and Franco flexing next to each other, and you can see the clear...
You almost said naked.
No.
Sorry, just keep going.
That's the other picture that was on Doug's hard drive.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's kind of what they're referring to, and... You know, aesthetics in physique competition sports are more extreme, but they're based off of what we naturally would consider to be healthy. So a man with a small waist and wide shoulders, what does that usually mean? Well, it means he's lean. It means he probably has good testosterone levels, or at least it points in that direction. It means that he probably has good use of his arms and legs, which might have been beneficial in hunting and in running. You know, wide hips and narrow shoulders, probably you're not going to be able to throw as well or run as well. But, you know, what about women? Why do women have such wider hips than men do? Well, they need a wider pelvis to birth a child, so we consider that to be, you know, more attractive. Of course, smaller waist also.
It's really just leaner. An exaggerated version of that.
Yeah. Totally exaggerated.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. I mean, it's balance and symmetry. It's and I think a lot of the terms that I've sat with many competitors and you know, talked about other people on the stage. And I think probably 80% of what you hear is a bunch of fluff. You know, people acting smarter than what they really are, trying to sound like they know it. You know, the guy who's throwing like the random term, like Sal talking about sports. That's exactly what it sounds like to me when I hear guys talking about stuff like that. Cause it really just comes down to that, like having a really good looking physique, coming in super lean. So all the muscle is defined. And the smaller the waist, the broader the shoulders for a male in bodybuilding, I think, and the better they're going to score.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, if you don't care about competing, which is 99% of the people listening right now, this is what you do. Train your whole body. Don't leave out an area. Train lots of different movements. Make sure you squat. Make sure you press. Make sure you row and you pull. Make sure you twist and rotate with your exercises. Make sure you do split stance type squatting exercises. Do all those things. Develop your whole body. Maintain a decent body fat percentage by not overeating and eating a healthy diet. And you're going to look phenomenal. Don't worry about all these insane terms and how you can exaggerate your...
Translucent delts, bro.
Yeah, that's not...
that's not what...
Yeah, you don't want translucent delts. That means they're not there.
Oh, man.